So what we've done for other sectors, sugar, cement, you know, basically, is almost like what they call a backward integration plan. What it is like you give incentives to people for producing locally on the ground. And as they produce, before the production is at the quantity you require, you allow them to import some of the deficits or whatever gap there is. And then over time, you close that gap with local production. That's what we're implementing for local tomato manufacturers as well.
Well, you've got a lot of experience in investment banking, and the SMEs here, it's huge. Many of them are almost crumbling under the weight of interest rates, double digits. They just wonder, when are we ever going to access credit at single interest rates?
So there are three things we're doing for SMEs, and we need to do better. I'm now using doing instead of we're going to do. Three things we're doing for SMEs. One is that SMEs pay a disproportionately higher cost when the cost of doing, whether it's cost of power or cost of doing business is higher. So they actually benefit disproportionately when you lower those costs, just the environment. And I would say for that reason, even if it's that reason alone, we need to be very aggressive in lowering the cost of power and the cost of doing business in general, because SMEs benefit from it even more than the big companies. That's number one. Number two is what you talk about financing. Through the Bank of Industry and other agencies in Ministry of Industry, Trade and Investment, as well as other government programs like the social intervention programs or social investment programs, we are targeting them, the most vulnerable in society, and many of them are SMEs, the micro, the small, the medium enterprises. We basically want to make sure that if you look at, for instance, the social investment programs, you know, there is money there for market women, for artisans, you know, for farmers, basically to give them, you know, the money they need to trade, because, you know, it's not a lot.
I'm happy that you're championing the cause of SMEs, and I think that, well, you said that we'll, over time we'll see the results. But then there are also questions as to those who are employed by, you know, all those who will be employed by the people who will come in to invest. Do you have any plans? And this might fall very strongly under the Ministry of Labour. But then are there plans to protect, you know, the labor markets and to ensure that, you know, people are not abused only and simply because we have, you know, external investors?
I think there are two ways to protect the labor market. By far, the most sustainable way is to create conducive environment for employment, right? You know, where people need to grow their businesses, because businesses are growing, they need more people, and frankly, it's competitive, and if you don't pay them well, they, you know. So that needs to go on, and that has to do with the economy itself in general. I mean, the second thing that we're doing, which is the one that falls under the Ministry of Labour, is better labour relations in general, you know, with employers, and attempt to include packages for employers so that they can employ more people. And
are we also looking at ensuring that, you know, job the Nigerians can do are done by Nigerians?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, I mean, it's part of this local content that we've talked about. Buy Nigeria, which is basically buying things we produce, employ more Nigerians. So when we work with foreign investors now, it's a very specific area of interest. You know, how they're going to train Nigerians, how they're going to, you know, have a program for developing Nigerians and for employing Nigerians. And I think it's something that, that we're
because
committed
people
to.
Have raised questions now about the construction, some of the construction companies. And as far as they're concerned, they clearly see that, you know, some jobs the Nigerians can do, this will be done by foreigners. And they're wondering, do government officials see this as well?
That's something, no, we do. And that's something we're paying a lot of attention to. And I think it's just, it will get better and better. But there's no question that every country protects its own citizens. I mean, I think it's just smart policy, right? I mean, you wouldn't have a country with the population we have, and you are importing, you know. So I think that generally, I can say it's part of our commitment going forward.
Are we looking at a brand policy to ensure that Nigerian brands are promoted even at the government level?
Yes, and I think it's both brand and, you know, plain procurement, right? Procurement policy. So part of our procurement policy, which is there, but we just need to reinforce it, re-energize it, is Buy Nigeria. We've been talking about it, you know, to the point where, you know, starting with government, leading by example to say, we'll buy Nigerian products where they're available as a matter of policy, and as a matter of even regulation, frankly, and then promote it, which is where it becomes brand, for Nigerians as well, Nigerian companies, Nigerian individuals, to buy Niger, buy Nigeria. So I think that's a very key part of, you know, localization, industrialization, diversification. And these are all things that need better implementation, but there is no question that that's the way to go.
Honorable Minister, I'm afraid I have to put this question to you again,
please.
Because you said you did admit that you do see some of these people come in, you know, this, especially in construction firms. I do know that we do have relations with some of these countries, and they're bringing in their money as well. Mm-hmm. Is it always a part of the agreement that they're allowed to also bring in their people?
Well, what I mean, I will answer it in a different way. Basically, part of the agreement is that they must employ Nigerians. I mean, at least where government is involved. Remember that some of these people that work for government, we have terms of engagement. And I know for sure that where that is the case, you know, employment of Nigerians is a condition. And in any event...
Do you enforce? Are you able to monitor to and enforce?
I think the immigration people are able to enforce. And secondly, Nigerians, even Nigerians themselves are able to enforce. The unions are able to enforce. I would say in general, this is an area that, you know, you will see more and more evidence that that is the case. I believe that that is the case today. You know, you need to go to other countries to understand what it means to be invaded by foreigners. You know, I think the bigger problem we have, and I agree with you that we need to enforce that, but the bigger problem is to create the opportunity. I don't think the Nigerian... You know, that if you had opportunities where you're employing more and more people in construction, that it's going to end up being Chinese or people from other countries. My sense is that we're going to employ Nigerians, and we do enforce.
Let me take this short, quick one before we wrap up. Dusumi Ojo says he's a young Nigerian farmer producing well-packaged gari, but for him to get certification from NAFDAC and SON, it's very difficult.
Excellent question. That's an example of where ease of doing business will help. You know, one of the things we're going to do with it is that we're going to say some of those agencies, people need to get their approvals within X time. Obviously, you have to do it.
Does your ministry liaise with all of those?
No, we will. There is an interministerial effort. This ease of doing business thing is a big deal. I just don't want to make too much noise about it yet until you see results. So it won't be like they talked the last time and they didn't do anything. But I can tell you that things like NAFDAC, things like SON, you will see results there. In the sense that, like, we're going to have timelines during which those things have to be approved. And... you know, it's either it'll be taken as it's approved silence, meaning consent, or, you know, there has to be some other intervention where there is a health risk involved that will address it and still make it easier for people to get what they need. Because I agree with you that that is the way to encourage and empower people, by giving them the approvals they need to produce.
All right, Kechukwu Enelama is the Minister of Industry, Trade and Investment. Thank you for coming on today.
Thank you for having me.
All right, then we'll be back in a moment. Don't go away.